Next is story sums. Example first, on a rainy day, Rahul collected 2/3 of liter of rain water in a bucket. After some time, he noticed that water was leaking out through a tiny hole in the bucket. If only 1/3 of a liter of rain water is left in the bucket, how much rain water has leaked out? That means इसमें क्या बताया कि राहुल ने रेन वाटर कलेक्ट किया एक बकेट में 2/3 ऑफ अ लीटर. उसके बाद क्या होता है, ही नोटिस द उसका जो वाटर है वो लीक हो रहा है बकेट में से, तो क्या होगा, ओनली कितना लेफ्ट रह गया 1/3 लीटर ऑफ वाटर. हाउ मच रेन वाटर हैज़ लीक्ड, वी हैव टू फाइंड हाउ मच रेन वाटर हैज़ लीक्ड आउट. सो फर्स्टली क्वान्टिटी ऑफ रेन वाटर collected in the bucket is equal to 2/3 of a liter. That means total part is 2/3. That's why we have write 2/3 of a liter. Next is quantity of a rain water left in the bucket, which is equal to 1/3 of a liter. So quantity of rain water that has leaked out, total minus 1/3. That means denominators are same, so we subtract numerators. 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1/3. That means 2 minus 1 upon 3, which is equal to 1/3. So 1/3 of a liter of rain water has leaked out of the bucket. Next is Nidhi ate 3/9 of watermelon while Parvati ate 4/9 of it. How much of the watermelon did they eat in all? That means Nidhi ate 3/9 of watermelon and Parvati 4/9. We have to find the total part of watermelon they both eat. So that means we are adding these numbers. Fraction of watermelon eaten by Nidhi, 3/9. And fraction of watermelon eaten by Parvati, 4/9. So fraction of watermelon eaten by both, that means 3/9 plus 4/9. So denominator is same, 9 adding numerator, 3 plus 4, 7. So Nidhi and Parvati together ate 7/9 of a watermelon. Next is 60 students of class 4th are going on a field trip and 3/4 of the students are bringing lunch from home. How many students are bringing their lunch from home? So total student 60 and 3/4 of 60, that means total 3/4 of students bringing lunch. We have to find how many students in numbers. Number of students going on a field trip 60. That means number of students bringing lunch from home, 3/4 of 60. So firstly, of means multiply. That means we have to multiply both the numerator. That means 3 multiply with 60, numerator and whole part. 3 multiply 60 is equal to 180. And after multiplying, we have to divide with by denominator. 180 divided by 4, which is equal to 45. So 45 students are bringing their lunch from home. Moving to our next question, Swati spends 7/8 of an hour reading storybooks and 3/8 of an hour playing in the park. On which activity did she spend less time and by how much? So firstly, we have to find on which activity did she spend less time and by how much. So how can we solve it? Firstly, write time spent. Time spent on reading storybooks 7/8 hours and time spent on playing in the park is equal to 3/8 hours. So less time spent on activity and how much we have to find how much. So 7/8 minus 3/8, which is equal to both the denominator are same, so subtracting both the numerators, 7 minus 3 4, and write 8 as it is. So 4/8, because 7/8 is greater than 3/8. Look at this. We have two circles. How many parts of circle? 8. Because denominator is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Similar in this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So now we have to shaded 7 portion of this circle. 5, 6, and 7. And how many left? 1/8. That means 7/8. Next is 1, 2, and 3. Only 3 parts are shaded of the circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are left. So 7/8 is greater than 3/8. Which is a less number? 3/8. So Swati spent less time, 4/8, in which activity? In playing in the park. So this is our answer. Next is, Palvi wants to complete 5/7 of crossword 2 days. She has already done 2/7 of the crossword. What fraction of the crossword is left for Palvi to finish? So we have to find what fraction of a crossword is left. That means we have to subtract both these numbers. So how can we do it? Palvi wants to complete crosswords 5/7. She has already done 2/7 crosswords. So left crosswords, that means total minus 5/7 minus 2/7. 5 minus 2/7, 5 minus 2, 3/7. 3/7 crosswords is left for Palvi to finish. Next is, fill in the missing numbers. We have given 2/4 is equal to 10/ this. We have to fill this box. So firstly, in which digit we have to multiply 2, we get 10. That means 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6, 2 4's are 8, and 2 5's are 10. So we multiply 2 with 5, that means 10. in which number we multiply with numerator, we have to multiply with the same number by denominator. That means 4 multiply with 5. 4 5s are 20. So here write 20. Next is 1 upon, we have to find this box, 6 upon 18. Which digit we have to multiply with 6? 1, we get 6. That means 1 multiply 6 is equal to 6. So if we multiply numerator with 6, then we multiply denominator by 6. That means number is 3, because 6 threes are 18. We get our answer. Next is, we have to find this number, numerator, denominator is 30. When we get the answer is 4 upon 5, it is a reduced form, because here 30 is a greater number and 5 is a smaller number. So we have to divide the number, that means we have to get this number. So 30, when we divide by 5 by 30, 5 6 are 30. So here we have to write those number, when we divide by 6, answer is 4. So 24 divided by 4, we get, sorry, divided by 6, we get 6. So 24 upon 30 is equal to 4 upon 5.